Hello and welcome.
We hope everyone is doing well in these uncertain times.
We are here to try and brighten your day with some incredibly witty skits.
From an incredibly talented auteur.
We must warn you that there is no overlying theme because this auteur is not that organized.
Everyone's working from home, which is great, but I guarantee that that person on the other end of that Zoom call isn't wearing pants.
Yes, that may be true, but Michael, we aren't working from home. We're in the studio, and I could have gone my whole life without knowing that you're a briefs guy.
What are you gonna do? Don't worry, folks, our stools are 6 feet apart, and it looks like Jan and I here had a bit of a miscommunication. This first skit is all about miscommunication. Let's have a listen.
How are you feeling? Over.
Sweaty. Over.
I meant, how are you feeling about the operation? Over.
My mistake. Let me rephrase. This operation is giving me the sweats. Over.
There is no need to worry.
And the runs. Over.
There is nothing to be nervous about, officer. Our surveillance is following you every step of the way, and the wire you're wearing will let us know if you're in trouble. All we need you to do is go with the gang you've infiltrated and capture the audio of the drug deal going down. Over.
You're right. I've worked too damn hard to let my nerves get the better of me at this critical moment. All I need to do is accompany them to the deal, stand in close proximity to capture the audio, and get home safe. Over.
And how did we discuss you going about this? Over.
By acting completely natural. Over.
Yo, man, you ready?
Hell yeah, my main man! How's it kicking, G? Everything good with you?
Idiot.
Alright, man, you've proven yourself to be trustworthy, which is why we want you to make the sale today.
Hey, cool beans!
Cool beans indeed. How about trading those finger guns for some real firepower? It could get hairy. Take this.
This isn't good. If you conduct the sale, then we'll only be able to get the incriminating audio on the party that buys from you. We won't be able to charge both gangs.
Hey, man,
over.
What's in your ear? Are you talking to someone?
Hell no, home slice. I wouldn't call it talking. More like I listen while my old lady nags my ear off. Who needs it?
Old lady? Hello? What happened? Did you destroy your earpiece? Over?
All right. Let's hop in the van. I want to be in time for MasterChef. I think Tracy has the determination and culinary know-how to bring this thing home. And I have my house riding on this thing.
Alrighty! Let's sell a drug or two, am I right? To the van! I call...
You call what?
You know...
Why do you keep looking down?
I'm holding a shotgun!
Let's go.
You know, the rest of you really should put on your seatbelts. It can be up to an $1,000 fine.
Why do you know that? What are you, a cop?
What? Nah, man. I hate the popo. You know, the fuzz? I've eaten donuts in better shape than those pigs.
Jesus. Why do you remove his earpiece? The wire's transmitting fine, but he can't hear me anymore.
Imagine how crazy it would be if we just turned ourselves in right now. Wouldn't that be hilarious?
Dude, why would you say that?
Oh my god, he's going to die. They won't be at the meeting place for another 5 minutes. I need some water. Oh, hey dude, I didn't expect to bump into you. You've been glued to your desk for hours.
Yeah, I'm overseeing a pretty big operation. I gotta make sure everything goes according to plan.
Same here. My dumbass officer panicked and crushed his earpiece.
Ha! So did mine. She's on her way to buy some drugs from a local gang, and she didn't want her cover to be blown. I was totally annoyed because I told her how important it was that she'd be able to hear me to avoid any possible miscommunication.
Wait, so your operation consists of your officer going undercover and buying drugs from a local gang?
Yeah? Why?
My undercover officer's local gang is about to sell some drugs. Abort! Abort! His earpiece, damn it!
Okay, let's do this, gang! Hello there, member of Arrival Gang.
Hello there, member of Arrival Gang to our Arrival Gang.
Oh no, they made contact with each other.
I might be in the business of distributing some drugs.
That's funny. I might, perchance, be in the business of obtaining said drugs via a monetary transaction.
Ah, how businesslike and illegal.
Indeed. How organized and premeditated.
Indeed.
And which types of narcotics do you have for sale?
Yes.
Splendid.
Indeed.
Riddle me this. Why were you late?
There was traffic.
That is understandable. It's funny how often those two things go together. Traffic, drugs, drugs, traffic, wouldn't you say?
Indeed.
Would you care to sell those many illegal substances that you have in your possession?
Only if you agree to purchase them and transfer them over to your possession.
Well, I will, if that is what you intend.
It seems that we have the same intent.
Indeed, it would.
Freeze! You're under arrest! What?
You guys are cops?
Well, this is awkward.
Indeed.
Edge of my seat, Michael. Edge of my seat.
I hear you, Jan. Oh boy, that sure was a roller coaster of emotions.
It sure excited me. But you know what excites me more? A good cup of coffee. At Starbucks, that first sip feeling never ends. We're told this next sip is all about how crazy that first sip feeling makes people. As a tribute, let's take a sip of our own Starbucks coffee. Yum. This skit will play after these messages.
I can't taste or smell anything.
Do you want to get away?
Is normal life just too exciting for you?
Well, then pack your kids and grab your bags, because Oakville is the place for you.
With not much to do and even less to see, Oakville is the only place you should be.
Oakville is calling.
Hi, welcome to Starbucks. How can I help you?
Hi, how are you doing?
Oh, I'm doing well, thanks. My shift is almost over, so I'm happy to be able to go home.
I'm happy for you. You guys always look like you're working so hard. I'll make it easy for you. Just a small black coffee, please.
Great. That'll be $2.15, please. Have a great day.
Thank you. You too. Here, I got the door, kid. Go on in.
Hi.
Hi. You are adorable. What can I get for you today?
Hi.
Hi. Can I get you a drink, buddy?
Yes.
Okay. What would you like?
Latte, almond milk, vanilla.
Alrighty. And what size would you like?
Big.
Okay. How are you paying?
Card.
Here you go, buddy. That was a very grown-up order.
For my mommy.
Aw, have a good day, okay?
Okay.
What a nice way to end a shift. He was so cute. Let's see. 20 minutes left until I get to go home. Hi, welcome to Starbucks. Well, how can I help you?
Yeah, hi. I would just like a black cup of coffee. Do you guys sell just regular coffee? None of that fancy stuff.
Yes, we do. Would you prefer a specific roast of coffee?
Listen, sweetheart. I'm a simple man with simple tastes. I don't have time for any of these gimmicks that make up what your generation calls a coffee shop. I am a busy man. Do you see how much this watch is worth? Maybe there wouldn't be so much student debt if young people could resist a $6 cup of unicorn piss every morning.
And how will you be paying for this, sir?
I found some change in my car.
Do you know how much this is?
What? I'm supposed to know? What are you getting paid for?
25 cents, 30 cents, 40 cents, 55 cents, 80 cents, 85 cents.
Oh wait, I have more. I've got a meeting in 10, so could you,
Have a nice day.
Sure.
Hi.
I saw on TikTok that you guys sometimes do designs on the foam. Can you do one on my latte?
Yeah, sure.
Oh my god, thanks. Okay, so I'm a Capricorn, so could your design like represent my ambitious and disciplined nature?
I can do a leaf.
Eee, thanks.
Next.
Coffee.
And how would you like...
Was this?
Your coffee?
I'm not an idiot.
I'm confused.
What am I supposed to do with this?
Drink it?
How?
Would you like a straw?
Don't be ridiculous. Anyone who grew up watching the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles know how important and awesome turtles are. The Starbucks near my old house would hold the drink up for me to sip because I don't have time for such trivial things.
But wouldn't you say this whole interaction that we've just had was way more trivial and time-consuming than lifting your own cup?
Listen, you seem nice, but my coffee's getting cold, so...
For the love of God.
Thanks. I'm really in a rush. This saved me hours.
How?
My son came in here and you gave him the wrong drink. I wanted soy milk with sugar-free vanilla. Are you trying to kill me?
Oh, I'm sorry. I only made what he asked for. I think there may have been a miscommunication.
Are you calling me a liar? Are you calling my son a liar? I won't stand for this garbage. I'll be suing.
Silly me. I should really put up a preventative wet floor sign. Oh, is she twitching?
A few moments later.
Hey, is your manager in? I need to speak with her.
Why? Did I not tuck your latte in and read it a bedtime story, you pretentious bastard?
I was hoping to talk to her about tonight's slipping incident. I'm the district manager.
Oh my god, I am so sorry. It's been a rough day.
That's okay. I just fired like 3 guys tonight and it's starting to bum me out. Don't let a real customer hear you talk like that.
Of course. Thank you so much. She's on her break, but I think she'll be back in 10.
All right, then. While I wait, could I get a Venti Skinny Vanilla Latte with 3 pumps of sugar-free vanilla, 3 shots of espresso, and half decaf? Thanks a bunch.
Wow, what a turn of events. Be nice to customer service people.
It's imperative that you control your temper.
Right you are, Michael, right you are. Let's take a look at this next skit, where two rivals let their temper get the better of them.
My head hurts a bit. Do you have any Advil?
Roll the clip!
Jenny! Jenny, it's on. Say your line.
Oh, shut up, Steve! Do you wish your coworker would just disappear forever?
That's not your line, Jen. It's do you wish your boss would disappear? Boss.
Well, Steve, I'm just being honest. At least one of us knows how to do that.
I said I was sorry. Jenny!
If you are just joining us, we are hour 17 of the never-ending race.
That's right, Jenna. We are witnessing history here today. What you are just tuning into, folks, is a grudge match between two veteran racers, Herschel Woods and Agatha Grease, both with impeccable careers in racing, earning both of them numerous accolades. The only other time these two raced one-on-one was 30 years ago, and they tied down to a tenth of a second. There is no time limit or lap requirement this time. This race ends when one of them is no longer able to stay on the track. To reiterate, they've been going on for 17 hours straight.
That is correct, Jeff. These two old-timers did not mince words when we interviewed them today. Here's a clip of that now. So, I understand it was the two of you who came up with these peculiar set of rules?
Why, yes, that is correct. There's more to racing than speed. It's about stamina, determination, and gusto.
I hope your pit crew also knows how to do diaper changes.
How dare you mock me on live audio? Of course they do.
Racers, how long ago did this feud begin?
Well, see, I can't remember per se, but I do know it was important.
All those sharp and sloppy turns must have jostled your brain loose.
Oh yeah, Mr. Tide Brain. Why don't you tell her what we've been competing for?
I think speed was involved. And efficiency. Definitely something about going round in circles.
Thank you, racers. I wish you both the best of luck out there.
Well, this certainly seems like a sensitive issue. Let's take a look back at the track.
The two are neck and neck, which is weird considering that's not what is required to win this race.
Wait, let's take a closer look. It appears Agatha is somehow driving while also mooning Herschel.
What a sight! Wait, what's this? It appears that Herschel has thrown a banana peel out his window and in front of Agatha's car.
Ha ha ha! It looks like someone has been playing too much Mario Kart with their grandkids.
Oh my!
It appears that Herschel was so busy laughing at the crash that he lost control of his own vehicle. They both have incredibly skilled pit crews who have been with them throughout their careers, but both teams will have to get creative if they want to keep this race going.
What's this? It appears that in the lieu of fixing the totaled cars, both racers have mounted horses.
I'm gonna get you for that.
It appears that Agatha's pit crew is outfitting her with armor that resembles that of the medieval era.
And it appears that Herschel has followed suit.
Suit of armor, that is.
They have abandoned all hopes of completing the race, and it appears that this has turned into a full-on joust.
After a devastating blow by both parties, they have fallen off of their horses.
Devastating blow? My grandma can joust better than that.
Ha ha ha, that's just a figure of speech.
Just ask my grandpa.
Ha ha ha, I'll be sure to give him a call sometime.
You can't. He, got jousted.
Oh, well. What an exciting turn of events this has been. Nearly 20 hours of racing and 10 seconds of jousting makes this the longest race I've ever had the pleasure of being a part of.
You said it, Jeff. They may joust like my grandpa, but they race like pros. Thank you all for tuning in. We're signing off.
So, can I take you to dinner?
Are you prepared to joust my grandma for my honor? Didn't think so.
Denny's?
Yeah.
I'll drive.
Please. They'll be closed by the time we get there.
Oh boy, oh boy. Too fast, too furious. That's what I say.
Oh yeah, what a ride. I would like to meet that grandma.
You know, as hosts, our job of describing the world ends when that little green light turns off. I wonder what it would be like to let it go on forever. Let's find out after these messages. Hey there, folks! Are you tired of your kids always?
Hey! Who turned off the lights? I didn't get to say my part!
Oh, stop your whining, Mike. You sound like an infant. On and off the radio.
But I can't see my script!
My bad, y'all. Oh, heck, it'll take me a good 20 minutes to change that bulb there.
Thanks, Jimbo. God. Mike, turn off the recorder. It's over.
No, Cassie. I won't stop. Not until I can say my...
This is Todd. Todd is eating ice cream. Todd seems to have forgotten about his late night chat with the mirror, in which he outlined exactly why tomorrow, now today, would be the first day of the rest of his life. Alas, here we are. Todd is eating ice cream. Perhaps those abs will form out of a sense of self-pity. Todd doesn't like to work for things, though. Todd waits for good things to happen to him.
I don't think that's entirely fair. I do things.
You can hear me?
Yep.
You let me go on for so long. I insulted so much about who you choose to be as a person. You just sat there and took it?
I didn't want to interrupt. Plus, I was feeling lonely.
Oh, Todd. Well, this is awkward. I'm gonna go.
You could stay. I don't mind.
All right, if that's what you want.
Okay, I'm gonna head home.
Todd?
Mm-hmm?
You don't have to do that. I do that.
Oops, sorry.
Todd is heading home. Todd is driving home. Yes, he is a swift head. Todd is what they show reformed bullies to make sure they've really left their old ways behind. This is not fair. Even nice people make fun of Todd.
I mean, I don't know if I would necessarily agree. I've had some very pleasant interactions.
Todd doesn't deserve most of the ridicule.
That's the nicest thing anyone has ever said to me.
Aren't you gonna do something?
I wanted to be polite and wait for you to tell me what it was I was going to do.
You can do small things by yourself. I don't need to narrate everything. I'm not obsessed. Todd is getting out of his car. I know what you're thinking. Yes, Todd really does live like this. It's beyond words.
Aren't words sort of your job? What if the audience can't see? This would feel like just a tease.
Wow, Todd. Wow. Here's something that doesn't need words.
My dominoes.
I said it didn't need words, Todd.
Well, maybe for you, or whatever sick ghouls are listening. But I was merely conveying my dismay at the fact that you flicked my domino. No matter. It was a side project. I'll get it up and running again in a few days.
Todd had spent 4 months on his dominoes.
Yeah, well, the only person who looks like a fool here is you. You flicked the middle domino. Everyone knows you start with the first one, idiot. What am I supposed to do with the first half of my dominoes? Flick them over? Rebuild? Take a picture? See? This is why people start with the first domino. I didn't even think you were a tangible being. How did you even touch my dominoes?
You wouldn't get it. Nobody gets it. I've spent all my existence narrating other people's lives that I never got to have one of my own.
I will try to get it. I'll listen.
After a long talk with this Todd, The narrator had gotten a lot off his chest, and for the first time in his life, he felt understood. After that day, he decided to narrate his own life, because while it might not be as exciting as knowing every secret about everyone, at least this story was his. Now he drives home, thinking about how it felt not just to talk, but to have someone listen. And surprisingly, Todd had taught him a thing or two about himself.
When you wake up and find that what you're looking for has been here the whole time, if you could see the light.
Truly moving, Michael. Truly moving indeed. I think I'm in the mood to listen to some old T. Swift now. What do you say to that, Michael?
I'm feeling tired. Oh, sleepy time.
Michael? Michael! Oh my god, that came out of nowhere! Or did it? He had a dry cough, sore throat, a headache, and he was clearly extremely fatigued. Oh no, those are all symptoms of COVID-19. Wait, someone fetch me a measuring tape. Okay. Let's see how far apart our stools are. What's this? We're only 4 feet apart? Oh, God.